This is Steve Marsh's farm, located in Cogginup, Western Australia. Steve is one of many farmers in Australia working to bring high-quality organic foods to market. He loves his land, he loves growing organic, caring for his grain and raising his sheep. But recently, something happened that may cost him and his family their farm.
Neighbour informed us he was going to grow GM next door. We had some strong winds come in and that proceeded to blow the swath canola, GM canola, across and contaminate approximately 70% of my farm.
Legislation did not have any statutes that required strict controls on GM farms, did not require precise registers of where plantings occurred, GPS locations, size and so forth. It did not require buffer zones beyond a voluntary system of 5 metres.
We've lost our certification. It's had a, you know, it's had a dramatic impact on our financial situation. Nobody wants to take their neighbour to court. The problem we found ourselves in, you just can't have such an impact on your livelihood, loss of income. At the same time, you know, you have to protect yourself from the liability issues as well, and so. Yeah, there was no other way to really go about addressing this issue.
While Steve practices organic farming, and this is a vital issue for the organic industry, contamination like this has the capacity to also gravely affect conventional, non-GM farmers. What happened to Steve has already happened to other farmers.
There's been a lot of concerns and proven risks to human, animal and environmental health as a result of releasing transgenic plants and products into our food system.
It's important to realise that this is a landmark case. This is going to determine whether or not people can actually farm in the way they choose to farm.
It's about protecting that right to choice. The choice of Steve to grow food the way he wants to grow it, and the choice of us to all eat GM-free foods if we want to.
It's very clever by the GM industry to say we'll use common law to defend yourself and pursue it. The problem we found is you lose a large part of your income, and then it costs you so much to take it to courts, particularly in a case like this where your opponents are very well organised and very well resourced. And it's been a huge relief for Safe Food and others to come in and support us. And obviously it shows a high level of concern in the community. We'd made that commitment, I discussed with my wife. We believe we're doing the right thing, and we made that commitment, whatever the outcome, win or lose. And obviously we were prepared to put the farm.
for Steve to take this stand, it's very easy for us to sit back and go, well, that's great, Steve, doing it, and good luck, mate, and hope, you know, hope it goes well. But I think it's also a matter of us providing support to Steve. Because what Steve's doing is fighting that one big battle for everybody. And really, everyone has an interest in this case should get behind and support Steve. Because otherwise what happens is every farmer has to fight a Steve Marsh case, and that's hard to do.
I support Steve Marsh's case to ensure that farmers have the right to grow GM-free food for all of us.
Steve Marsh may be in Western Australia, but he's actually in your pantry, in your fridge, in your local supermarket, wherever and whenever you put something in your mouth, Steve Marsh is there. We need to get behind him. Join me and the Safe Food Foundation in supporting Steve for your health and mine too.
Big things grow from little things. Big things grow from little things. Big things grow from little things. Big things grow from